Are you ready to unlock your full potential? Imagine being able to adapt to any situation, overcome any challenge, and achieve greater success than ever before. That might be possible thanks to neuroplasticity. This is an incredible ability of your brain to reorganize itself and form new neural connections in response to new experiences. By harnessing this ability, you can enhance your personal development and achieve success in both your personal and professional life. Join us in this video as we guide you through the essential aspects of neuroplasticity and how you can benefit from it. I am Linda Granforce.
And I am Alessandro Carpentiero. We at Beyond Sapiens help you and your team achieve work-life balance and sustainable performance.
To better explain the concept of neuroplasticity, it's essential to understand that your brain is not a static, fixed organ, but rather a dynamic and adaptable one. This means your brain can change and reorganize itself in response to new experiences, learning, and challenges, because that is what it's made for. In other words, neuroplasticity refers to the brain's ability to rewire and restructure itself based on new input and experiences. This ability of the brain to change and adapt is excellent news, because it means that our genetic makeup or past experiences do not limit us. Instead, we can continue to learn, grow, and improve ourselves throughout our lives, regardless of age or previous experiences. This also means you can intentionally shape your brain to develop new skills, behaviors, and habits that serve your personal and professional goals. But all this requires you to change something in your thinking, behavior, or environment, because otherwise your brain follows its old common pattern. For example, if you want to break a bad habit of biting your nails, you can replace it with a positive one, such as squeezing a stress ball. By doing this consistently, you can help your brain to rewrite the pattern of biting your nails by squeezing the stress ball and helping you change your behavior by training your brain to change.
So how can you use neuroplasticity for your personal and professional growth? First, we need to understand the role of neural pathways, which we can visualize as roads in the brain that connect different parts of it and allow information to flow between them. So just like how you can take different routes to get from one place to another in a city, your brain can use different neural pathways to process information and carry out tasks. When you learn new concepts or skills, your brain creates new neural pathways or strengthens existing ones, making it easier for you to recall that information or perform that skill in the future. So just like a city can expand and develop new streets and roads, your brain can do the same through practice and repetition. So by intentionally creating new neural pathways and strengthening existing ones, you can improve your cognitive abilities and develop new skills to support your personal and professional growth. One way to do that is by challenging your brain with new and complex tasks. For example, you could learn a new language, play a musical instrument, or solve puzzles. These activities stimulate the brain and help to create new neural pathways, making it easier for you to remember, concentrate, and think creatively. And the beautiful thing is that you never know how these new connections will serve you in the future. For example, Steve Jobs studied calligraphy back in college. It was something pretty pointless at the time, but 10 years later, he connected the dots and made custom fonts an integral part of the Macintosh. We all can do the same in our own unique ways. For example, I studied music, design, and photography for many years of my life. These fields are totally unrelated to what I'm doing now at Beyond Sapiens, but somehow, all the neural pathways I created in the last 3 decades significantly contribute to my present self and how I think and behave. Besides this, another useful technique for enhancing cognitive abilities is through mindfulness and meditation. Research has shown that both practices can help increase focus and concentration, reduce stress, and improve overall cognitive abilities. On top of that, they can also increase gray matter in the brain, which is associated with memory, decision-making, and emotional regulation. So if you don't have meditation as a regular practice in your day yet, maybe this could be the right moment to start.
Besides meditation, also what you do, say, and think affects your level of success. For instance, let's say you want to become a successful public speaker. To start the process, you can begin by visualizing yourself confidently speaking in front of a large audience, feeling calm and collected. Research has shown that visualization can activate the same areas of the brain that are involved in actually performing the task or reaching the goal you are visualizing. For example, if you visualize yourself giving a successful speech, the same areas of your brain that would be activated during an actual presentation are stimulated, leading to increased confidence and skill. Another powerful tool for rewiring your brain is positive self-talk. By consciously using affirmations and other positive statements, you can train your mind to focus on the good things in your life. This can help you feel more confident, resilient, and empowered, helping you build success in your life. For example, instead of saying, "I'm not good at public speaking," try saying, "I am confident and articulate when I speak." Studies have shown that when you think positively, your brain releases neurotransmitters like dopamine and serotonin, which can improve your performance, mood, and overall well-being. In contrast, negative thoughts can activate the amygdala, the brain's fear center, leading to feelings of anxiety and stress, disturbing your performance. By consciously focusing on positive thoughts and beliefs, you can create new neural pathways in your brain that support a more optimistic and resilient mindset, allowing you to perform and succeed as you aspire. Lastly, deliberate practice. If you want to improve your public speaking skills, you can practice by recording yourself speaking, listening to it, and identify areas where you can improve. You can also join a public speaking club or take courses to learn specific techniques and get feedback from others. This way, you can create new neural pathways that support your goals as you focus on specific skills and areas where you want to improve. Over time, these new behaviors and thought patterns can become automatic, leading to greater success in your personal and professional life.
Most people stop studying and learning new things after high school or college. After all, our brains stop developing at 25 years of age, so what's the point in continuing to learn? Just like we need to continue eating and drinking water to maintain our bodies, our brains also require constant stimulation and learning to keep functioning optimally. As we have seen, the brain is capable of rewiring and making new connections throughout our entire life through neuroplasticity. But what's the caveat? This process requires active engagement, meaning that we must put effort into challenging ourselves with new experiences and learning opportunities. A great way to do that is by embracing lifelong learning. After all, the more you learn, the more you can develop and improve personally and professionally, ultimately shaping the life you desire. There are many ways to continue learning throughout your life, such as taking courses, attending workshops, reading books, or just learning from your daily experiences. What matters is that you make these practices part of your routine by building goals and daily habits that support your learning. For example, you could start with the goal of reading one book per month on topics that can help you get further with your career. How can you do that if you're already spread thin? Just build the habit of listening to an audiobook for 30 minutes during the day. You could do that while commute to and from work, so you wouldn't have to take time out of your busy schedule. And just like magic, you will listen to 130 hours of good books during the working days in a year, which translates to around 11 to 17 books. Not bad, right? But this isn't enough. To fully leverage the power of lifelong learning, you also have to develop a growth mindset. A growth mindset means embracing challenges, persisting through obstacles, and seeing failure as an opportunity for growth. With a growth mindset, you believe that your abilities and intelligence can be developed through hard work and dedication, rather than being fixed traits that cannot be changed. As Henry Ford famously said, "Whether you think you can or you think you can't, you're right."
We hope you have gained some valuable insights on how to use your brain's neuroplasticity to your advantage. If you or your team would like to learn more about optimizing your mind, body, and work for success, we would love to help you. Feel free to email or book a slot through our calendar link below if this could be something for you. We look forward to meeting you.
And if you want to gain innovative ideas and solutions to maximize your mind, body, and work, please subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss our weekly research-based videos. Thanks a lot for watching, and we'll see you next week.